Hey everyone, it's Emily, and welcome to another Speed Build. Today we are doing a family home that's kind of like fall inspired. I think I ended up taking the screenshots in fall. I'm not totally sure, but I built this kind of a while ago. I don't know, I've been building so many things recently, and I feel like I haven't posted on my channel in forever, even though it's really only been a few days, but that's kind of a long time for me because I used to upload it the very least like every other day, and for a while, it's actually been a while since I did daily uploads, but it still feels like not that long ago I was doing daily uploads, so I don't know, it feels weird for me to go like more than 3 or 4 days without uploading. But basically, there've just been some kind of unfortunate circumstances and then just me kind of forgetting about the circumstances and not planning very well. So it's all my fault, but it's fine. I have lots of builds that I've been working on in the meantime, even though I haven't really completely finished much. I actually have this build and then another build that are completely ready to go other than, you know, the voiceover and stuff. But other than that, they're totally done. So I'm very happy about that. But I have about 8 other house builds that are like in progress at the moment. They're at various stages of doneness. Some of them are completely done on the outside, but then they need the entire floor plan and interior furnished. Some of them are almost done, they just don't have the landscaping. Some of them are like they've got a couple rooms furnished, but not quite everything. So we're getting there, but we'll be seeing some of those come out on the channel as I'm starting training for my new job, because I start that when is it from when you guys are gonna see this? If you see this tomorrow, that's like a week and a half. Oh, by the way, let me talk about the build for a second, because this is my favorite part of this build. This like glass roof section. I am really, really loving using the glass roofs, and then you'll see a thing that I do later to make it look like there are beams in the ceiling, and I just really love it. I'm obsessed. So you'll be seeing that in some of my builds that are coming out on the channel. I don't think that there's a single build that I've done that doesn't have glass roofs in the past couple days or weeks, whatever. But yeah, I'm really into the glass roofs and making them a little bit different with the beams and stuff. I really like doing that now. So anyway, like I was saying, I've had some unfortunate circumstances with my time to record, and I haven't had as much time because my parents are renovating their bathroom. I don't know how often I've mentioned it on my channel. I think I've mentioned it a couple times. So sorry if I've mentioned it like a billion times, and this is just really redundant, but they're redoing their bathroom. When they're done with theirs, they're gonna be doing mine, but I will be gone by the time they're working on mine, so I won't really have to be dealing with that. I will be at my house because I'm moving out for the school year, but I am having to deal with their bathroom not being done and construction going on. And I also am done with work for the summer, so the summer job that I had is over. My last day was this past Thursday, if you're watching this around the time that I'm uploading it. If you're not, then, you know, here's a little story about what's going on with me around the end of July in 2018. But yeah, their bathroom situation, I kind of forgot that during the day, you know, the workers are here because I've been at work all summer, so I didn't really think about that. And then I've planned a lot of things, like I've done a lot of things in the evening when the workers are gone, and then some stuff in the morning before they get there, and then thinking like, oh, I can finish a voiceover later this afternoon, or oh, I can record a Let's Play part like later this afternoon. And then the workers get here and I'm like, oh shoot, they're gonna be here until 5, and then I have to stream later, and then I'm not gonna have time to get this video done when I wanted it to be done. So that's kind of why there's been a little bit of lack of videos. Mostly it's just my fault for not realizing that the workers are obviously gonna be here all day, and not really planning for that. But to my defense, I wasn't really used to having to deal with that during the day because I was at work, so I didn't really think about it when I was thinking about being home. I was like, oh, I'm gonna have so much more time to do stuff, I'm gonna be so productive during the day, and then I spent my time in the evenings building stuff, then thinking that I could be more productive during the day and edit the videos and do voiceovers and stuff and record Let's Play parts, and then I just kind of forgot that that's when the workers are gonna be here most of the time. So that's been kind of sad. And for those of you who keep up with my upgrowth challenge, we will be having a part coming out this Friday. I missed this past Friday, and that was just because of me not planning well when I was gonna record it because of workers being here. And then it kind of got to being the day of on Friday. And I was thinking, oh, like worst case scenario, I just do it in the morning. And then it was the morning and I woke up and the workers were here. And I was like, okay, well, there goes that plan. I can't really record now. So that just kind of sucks a little bit. And I'm really sorry about that because it's totally my fault. But that's just what's been going on with me. And I think we're going to have about either two or three videos a week for the month, or through the end of the month of August is kind of the plan, because I have a job training for 2 weeks straight, and from what I've heard from people who have had the job before, I don't think that I'll have a whole lot of free time to be recording videos or playing the game or like being online in general. So those are going to be some long days, long 2 weeks, and then I start classes as soon as my job training is done. This is the part where I'm doing the Beam thing, so just pay attention if you want to see what I'm doing here. You can kind of see my process, and I'm sure people have tutorials of how to do this because I didn't come up with this on my own. I was actually watching someone who was building on stream. I can't remember who it was, but they were doing this Beam thing in their house and it looked really cool. So I thought that I would mix it with the glass roofs for an interesting effect. So that's what we've got going on there. Anyway, what was I saying? Something about, oh yeah, my schedule. So we'll only be having about two or three videos a week for the month of August and the rest of July because of my work training and stuff. I'm just really not gonna have time. And I also am starting to get ready to move and pack my things and clean my room at home and all of this stuff. So I just don't have as much time to pre-record as I would like to, but instead of promising too many videos, I would rather say, we're only going to have two or three a week and then maybe somehow be able to pull off more, but that's just what you should expect. At least two videos a week, and if I can manage, maybe three or four a couple times, but we'll just see how it goes. I'm kind of worried about this because they haven't given us a schedule yet for the training, and that makes me very anxious because I like to know things in advance, and it's getting to be like less than 2 weeks before I start 2 weeks of training, and I would kind of like to know what I'm going to be doing for those 2 weeks, but it's okay, it's fine. I'll keep you guys updated on Twitter and Discord about my schedule and my free time and such, if I have any free time. Oh gosh, here we go. Also, what I'm thinking is that for the training time, videos might be a little bit sparse, but when I start school on, I think the 21st is my first day of class, I might be wrong, but once I start school, I should be able to have some more free time to record stuff, so that might be when we see a couple more uploads popping in that aren't pre-recorded, just because I should have time to at least make videos, even if it's not a ton of time, I should have time to make like a couple, but I'm not totally sure, so I just wanna have some stuff ready to go for when classes start so that I'm not scrambling to, you know, get ready for school and try to make videos. So that's just kind of the plan. Here's a nice channel update. Welcome to this house that I built. But yeah, that's what's been going on. Also, for those of you who watch my streams on Twitch, I'm not really sure when I'm going to be streaming during that time too, but I'll be keeping you guys updated in the Discord and on Twitter as per usual, and I'll be updating my stream schedule on Twitch. If I am able to stream, I'll make sure that it's on my little schedule thing on there too. Anyway, that's that. And also, if you like watching me stream on Twitch, I'll be streaming later today at 7 p.m. Eastern time, so make sure to tune in for that. I'm not sure what I'll be doing. Probably gameplay. I don't think I'll be building, but I might. I don't know. Who knows? I never really decide what I'm doing until like a couple hours before I'm streaming, because sometimes my mind changes. Like in the morning, I'll wake up and I'll think that I want to do one thing, and then it gets to be time to stream, and I'm like, I don't feel like doing that anymore. So now I don't really have a schedule for streams. But in case you're new, the things that we have been playing on stream are the 100 Baby Challenge and the Family Dynamics Challenge. Family Dynamics is like a 10 generation legacy challenge, and then the 100 Baby Challenge is we're just trying to have 100 kiddos. So far we've moved out 4, which I'm very pleased with, and we're looking to move out a few more, and our sim, aka Bella Goth, she's pregnant, and she's actually pregnant with Father Winter's kids. It's just, it's a time over there. That's actually kind of a fun little story. We had our first Winterfest, I guess it's called. And we actually started in winter once we got seasons. So I wanted to start each of my save files in a different season. So I picked winter for the 100 baby challenge, and Father Winter came over, and she was already pregnant at the time, actually. But, you know, we just got a little bit flirty. It went very well. He asked her on a date later, and then she had her babies that she was pregnant with on Winterfest. And then, you know, we promptly invited Father Winter back over, and he came over, and then now she's pregnant with Father Winter's kids. So it's just a time. It's a fun time. Oh, also, this little spot of the build that I'm about to do, I really like it. It's like a cute little kids play area. It's basically just a bunch of seating and chairs and stuffed animals and things, but I end up putting some rugs and a little tea set in the middle, so I was thinking they're like playing tea, and that's kind of cute. And then there's kind of like space for a reading nook. Since they do have all those bookshelves over there, you could use this as like a reading nook. I mean, kids just read wherever they want. It's not like you really use it as anything. But yeah. Ooh, I also wanted to give them a little globe because I feel like kids love like spinning globes and stuff. I don't know. Was that just me? Probably. Maybe. Who knows? But anyway, I feel like I haven't done a speed build voiceover in about a million years, so sorry if I'm a little bit off, but that's just where we're at. I don't really know what I'm doing anymore. Oh, I do know what I'm doing. I basically didn't know what I was saying anymore, but I figured it out. Also, I used to do a lot of videos every week. Like, I used to post 5 times a week, and I feel like that's just not manageable for what I'm wanting to do with my channel at the moment. I really, really like building bigger family houses. Like, by bigger, I mean like this size. Instead of before, I was more into like little cottages and apartments, and I was really enjoying building those. But now I'm really liking building big family houses and putting a lot of time into them. Like, this house probably took me like 4 hours. Also, sorry if you can hear my dog. She's barking at something. Who knows? But this build probably took me like 4-ish hours, and that's probably a long time for some people for a house this size, but for me, that's kind of average, and I'm really happy with how it turned out. And I feel like in the past, I have kind of rushed builds or put out builds that I wasn't 100% happy with just because I felt like I needed something to go up for the day. And once again, dog is barking. Hold on a second. Okay, I think she's done. But anyway, I have definitely put up some builds that I wasn't 100% feeling like they were the best work that I've done, just because I needed something for the day and it was finished or almost finished, so I just kind of forced myself to finish it and then put it up, and then I would kind of feel like I didn't really do my best on that, like I'm not fully happy with this. And something that when I started my YouTube channel, I didn't want to do was like be too much of a perfectionist about it, so I just told myself like, oh, it's fine, like you're just being too picky. But then now I've realized that there's a difference between being picky and nitpicking when I'm editing and things like that versus, you know, not being fully happy with content that I'm creating. I think there's a little bit of a difference. It's very like small difference. I think it's a fine line, but for example, I would rather spend a lot of time on a build and then just kind of like do a rambling voiceover and hope that people are okay with it than spend, you know, like an hour or two on a house that I don't like and then just keep going with it and finish it off just because I need something for the day, and then still, you know, do a rambly voiceover that's whatever. But yeah, I don't know. I don't know if that makes any sense. I don't know what I'm saying anymore, but yeah, basically we might see a few less uploads than we're used to, those of you who have been around for a while, because I don't know, I just really want to be happy with what I'm posting, and for a while I wasn't, and I feel like I'm finally starting to get back to a point where I feel good about things that are going up. Like this house, I'm really, really happy with this house. I have a house that's going to go up this weekend. I'm really happy with that house, and almost everything that I'm working on right now, there are a couple builds that I'm not fully happy with, but I still quite haven't let them go because I have spent a lot of time with them, and I'm going to see if I can make it work, but if not, I might end up scrapping them, and that's okay because they're not my best work and I'm not fully happy with them. And I don't know, I just feel kind of bad when I post something that I'm not 100% on. Oh, also that corner of the house, I don't know if you guys caught that, but it's like an empty corner in the living room, which is very unlike me. I like to fill up every space, and I was looking specifically for that one corner shelf unit thing. It's not really a shelf unit, it's just like a decorative object, but it's this corner that's on the right of the screen right now, but it comes in Cats and Dogs, I want to say, and Yeah, it does. It's from Cats and Dogs. And if you build a lot, you probably know what I'm talking about. Oh, I put a painting there. That makes me feel a little better. But I was going to put that item right in that little corner and then I forgot. So, whoops. Oh, well. But the fact that I put a painting there. Oh, I moved the painting. Dang it. Okay, now we have an empty corner again. It's okay. I'm fine. But anyway, see, now this is what I'm talking about. I feel like there's a difference between being not fully happy with a build because I feel like it's not my best work versus like, oh, there's this one little tiny part that isn't right. I'm not posting it anymore. You know, does that make sense now? I don't know. Maybe it made sense before. Maybe it doesn't. Maybe it still doesn't make sense. Whatever. Moving on. I'm working on lots of things that I'm really excited about. They are bigger. They take me more time. I can't bust out like three or four of them a week like I could with smaller little cottagey builds or apartments or something like that. And I'm also part of why I didn't put out an episode of my upgrowth challenge. I couldn't remember the name of it for a second, but my upgrowth challenge let's play this past week was because I ran out of time to record it in time, and then I was like, well, I'll just put it off a few days and I'll just put it up late on Monday. And then it got to be when I should have been recording it and I realized, oh shoot, the construction people are here, can't do it. And then I thought about it and I was like, if I do it now, I'm gonna feel rushed and it's gonna feel forced, and I would rather just wait until the usual time when I record it during the week and go ahead and do it when I usually would, and then it'll be a better part, if that makes sense. I don't know if any of this makes sense. Maybe this is just overkill and you don't really need me to explain myself. That's all fine too. But back to the house a little bit. I was imagining that this family has kind of renovated some of this house, maybe, or maybe not. I don't really know. I didn't really think too much about it, to be honest. I was just doing some cool stuff, and then I was thinking they have some kids, so they have lots of kids stuff everywhere, and like they have their little chess nook that I was just working on, and their kids are in scouts or something. I was thinking that both of them are children, not there isn't any toddler stuff in the house really, and at least I don't think there is. And then I wasn't too sure if either of them were a teen. I was thinking they're both kids and they're kind of around the same age and they play together a lot and have friends over, so they have their big playroom and whatever. They also basically have a second playroom upstairs, which is kind of cool. I did some stuff with hallways in the upstairs that I don't usually do, and that was a little bit nice and different than what I usually do, like I said. But we've got an extra bathroom down here because I was realizing that we didn't have a bathroom on the first floor, and this house is kind of big, and this bathroom, even with this house having a bathroom on the first floor, it's kind of all the way on one end of the house, which is really inconvenient because it's on the opposite side of the living room where most people would be, presumably. So yeah, that's a little bit of an issue, but it's okay. I think it's fine. Sims don't really care, but just for my own personal like realism, I'm not too big of a fan of that. But anyway, at some point move objects got turned off and it started deleting my doors. So I was having to go around the house as I was working on different rooms and put doors back in, which was really frustrating. Sometimes I've noticed that if you don't have move objects on, when you go to place wall paint, it deletes doors and windows, which I think is really frustrating. Has anyone else had that issue? Because I know that I'm pretty sure that I've heard of other people having it, but it's been bothering me a lot recently, and yeah, I'm not a fan. But ooh, I think the tile I ended up using in here, yeah, it is. Okay, so this tile, technically it's like a diagonal floor tile if you use it on a regular room, but because this room is diagonal, it looked like a regular like square floor tile, and I thought that was kind of cool. But I haven't used the florist table in any of my builds yet, so I wanted to get that in here because they have this nice little room, and usually I would put like a woodworking bench there, but I thought why not just put the floristry table. And then, is it called floristry? Is that a thing? I don't even know if that's a thing. I don't know if that's the right word, but then we get some cute plants in there. And I originally was just gonna straight up make this into a home gym, but then I thought that we could put some other junk in here too. So that's what we did. And I used this extra space up here for a art room thing. There's an easel and then there's a kid's drawing desk, which, oh my gosh, I love the kid's desk thing that came with Seasons, the drawing table. Is that what it's called? The activity table, the craft table. I don't know, but it's really great. And also some of the interactions that came with Seasons with that table are incredible. There's one, I think you can make seasonal crafts. I've only done it with fall because my current household that I'm playing on stream just started fall. And so I had our artsy kid, I had him make some fall decorations at the table, and then I put them on the wall, and it was like they expanded. It was like he was drawing on a bunch of different pieces of paper, and it was all fall decorations, I guess, for the house. And when I pulled it up to put it on the wall, it wasn't just like the one sheet of paper like that kids usually draw on at the table. It was like 6 different things that he had done. One of them was like, you know how Thanksgiving, for those of you who live in America, those of you who don't, you probably won't understand this, but it's like you put your hand and you trace it and then you make it into a turkey. It was like one of those, but it also used like, it incorporated like a plate into it. I don't know, it was really cool, like a paper plate. Anyway, I just thought it was a really cute little detail that they added with the pack, and I don't know, it's the little things that make the game fun for me. But anyway, I also really like the shelf unit thing that I kind of squished together from a bunch of different objects, because we got the dark brown, and then that light brown went perfectly with the thing from Laundry Day. Are all of these from Laundry Day? Oh, they might be. These might all be from Laundry Day. Maybe that's why they go so well together. But still, I thought they looked really nice. And then that basket from Seasons with all the towels and stuff, super cute as well. And yeah, just getting some nice little clutter. This area right here of the hallway is kind of the kids' second playroom, I would say. I also imagined that this family had a cat. And ooh, another cute thing that I did that I thought was kind of clever. I didn't mention it when I was doing it because I was off on a tangent about making better quality content, basically. But I was thinking that they have a cat, and I actually put a pet bed in that little circle of chairs and stuffed animals that are having, like, they're like playing tea party or whatever. And I was thinking that the kids like dragged over the pet bed and put it in the circle with all the stuffed animals because they wanted the cat to play tea with them. Because that's totally something I would have done with my dog when I was younger. I think there's a video of me on Christmas, like, taking her paw and like using it to try to help her open her present. And I mean, that dog like definitely hated me, and that's probably why. But yeah, I feel like this is just a very like child thing to do. So I thought that that was a nice little touch that we have definitely passed in the build, but it's okay. I just like mentioning these things when I think of them, because I put a lot of thought into like really, really random minute details of the build, and then half the time I don't even talk about them because I'm off on a tangent when I'm actually doing that part. But you know what? We can just go back and revisit. We can pretend that everyone knows exactly what I'm talking about by the little tea party area of the house. It's fine. But yeah, then the kids actually have a way bigger bathroom than their parents, which is kind of interesting. But I guess I was gonna say there are two of them sharing it, but there's also two people sharing the parents' bathroom. So I don't know. They only have one sink in here, so that's okay. And it's just how it worked out with the floor plan. It would have been kind of weird to make this bathroom a different size, and I really liked what I did with the hallway and stuff. So this is what we ended up with. Oh well. And the master bedroom I also really like in this house. It has a very like yellowy brown, the kind of earthy toned color scheme. I don't know if earthy toned is the right word, but it's like very, I guess, golden. Maybe that's better, but whatever. It's a nice bedroom. It's fine. I like it. And something that I'm really starting to get annoyed with because I've been building so much is I really, really like doing the outside, and I like doing the landscaping, and the kitchen, living, and dining room is pretty much fine. Living rooms kind of start to bother me sometimes because I feel like I'm not doing it right. But then the bedrooms annoy me so much. And I think it's because I'm, especially kids' rooms, like I really like making kids' rooms. I think they're fun. But then I'm just imagining like someone downloading the house and deleting all of the stuff that I put in the bedrooms to customize it to their Sims. And I put a lot of thought into these bedrooms. And if you've ever downloaded one of my builds and have deleted stuff, like I don't really care that much. But just when I'm doing it, I'm like, oh, I don't really want to do this. And like I spend all the time doing the parts of the build that I actually like doing. And then the only things I have left usually are the bedrooms and stuff. And then I'm like, man, people probably don't even care about these that much, and now I have to finish it. So there's that. I actually left the landscaping in this build till the end, very much unintentionally. I've been doing that a lot. I used to do all of the landscaping as soon as I was done with the outside, but now it's like I do the outside and then I come back to it later and I just want to start working on the kitchen or something because I really like kitchens. So then I'll do the kitchen and then I'll just end up like starting to do the other rooms of the first floor, and then I'll end up doing the second floor, and then I'll zoom out and realize that I haven't done the landscaping. And I'm like, oh, I thought I was done with this. Especially because, okay, this curtain was giving me so many issues. It made me very upset. But I think, did I really just give up on it? Yeah, I think I gave up on that curtain. But anyway, I usually am like fine with the landscaping. I don't mind doing the landscaping. But after I finish my least favorite part of the build, and I think that it's the last thing I have to do, my least favorite part of the build being the bedrooms, and thinking that, you know, oh, I see the light at the end of the tunnel, I'm done now, like I finished the bedrooms, and then you zoom out and like you realize that there's no landscaping. And it's not even the landscaping that makes me slightly like sad when I realize, but it's the fact that I haven't done the backyard. And the backyards are so hard for me because I feel like there are so many good opportunities to like make backyards look really nice, but when I'm at this point in the build, I just want to be done. And I can do some nice landscaping pretty quickly, but the backyard is just not going to be quite as nice as I was originally intending it, I'm sure. So that's a little bit of an issue, but we're working on it. And with kids, I feel like you can just put some play equipment, and especially we have like the swing set now, you can just throw a swing set in the yard. It looks great. Everyone loves the swings. Everyone's excited about them. Finally, I got that curtain to work. Yeah, I don't know, if there aren't kids in the house, I just never know what to do for the backyards. They usually get some planter boxes, and that's about it. I also used to fill up my planter boxes with plants from the gallery, or I would like raise up some of the landscaping plants and use them as like fake plants in the planter boxes. But recently, by the time I've gotten to the backyard and actually doing that type of stuff, I've just been like, no, I don't feel like it. And I figure that that's, especially that part is like one part of the build where if people are going to use the planter boxes, they're just going to put in the stuff that their Sims do. And if they don't want gardening, they're just going to delete the planter boxes. So I feel like it's not the end of the world, but that's just a challenge that I've been facing recently. And this bedroom, I've decided to call the yellow and blue bedroom because it's very yellow and blue. The other bedroom was kind of like a mix of colors. It was mostly, I think, like red, blue, and orange, but this one is definitely very yellow and blue. Like those are the only colors in the room just about. And I realized that there wasn't a computer in the house, and that doesn't really bother me too much when I'm playing the game. My Sims don't usually go on the computer all that often, to be honest, but I feel like just for gameplay, it's nice to have one somewhere in the house. And especially if you use MC Command Center, having the computer to click on to control the settings is really handy. So I do like to put them somewhere in the build. So this kid is the lucky one with the computer, and I figured maybe they're a geek. They play some Void Critters. I don't know. Anyway, we're onto the landscaping. I cut out the tiniest bit of it, and actually I didn't even cut this build down that much, and that's probably why it's one of the longer builds that I've done recently on the channel, but I think that's okay. My voice is struggling a little bit because, like I said, I feel like I haven't recorded a voiceover in forever, and I feel like my voice also feels like that, and is not too happy with me for doing this, which you think it would be fine because I've been streaming a lot, and yeah, I usually stream for like at least 3 hours when I stream, but like I said, I haven't been doing voiceovers, and I think it's a lot. I don't know, I feel the pressure in voiceovers to like fill up the dead air, but in streams I feel a little bit more chill, so maybe that's why, because I'm not talking constantly, but with a voiceover I am. I don't know. I was gonna say you tell me, but like you probably don't know any better than I do. Ooh, this is something that I've been liking to do recently because I've been building in Brindleton Bay a little bit more. I used to build in Brindleton Bay all the time, and then I got into Newcrest, and then now I'm kind of into Willow Creek a little bit, so I'm just a little bit more all over the place. But I have been going back into Brindleton Bay, and something that drives me insane is this grass color, and it does get to be more green in summer, I've noticed, I'm pretty sure anyway, but when you put down some of the terrain paints that have grass in them, like the little stones with the grass in those terrain paints does not match the Brindleton Bay grass, and it's so infuriating. But what I've started doing to kind of counteract that problem is I'll use that terrain paint, and then I'll go in with a dirt terrain paint and make it very light, and then I'll just kind of go over the area. And also over here, this looks really stupid, but supposedly that sprinkler will cover all of those plants, so that's why I did that. I don't really like how it looks, but I thought it could be useful for gameplay, so that's that. Also, backyards, I was struggling, didn't really know what to do, so that's what we ended up with. But anyway, I'll use some of the dirt terrain paint over whatever stone slash grass terrain paint I've used in Brindleton Bay, and then it blends it in to the Brindleton Bay colored grass a little bit better. So that's just a little tip for you guys. If if you're also struggling with Brindleton Bay grass and terrain paints with stones, because I know that I have been, and it's just been a little bit of a mess, but that's okay. Anyway, we are just about done with this build, so I hope you guys enjoyed, and make sure to subscribe if you're new. I post at least 2 house builds every week, and that's about all I have for you guys. I hope you're having a great day, and thanks for watching. Bye!